Yo guys, what's up? Jonas here, and in today's video I'm going to show you how you can fix the Xbox One black screen or green screen of death, whatever you want to call it. But before I start this tutorial, I would really appreciate it if you could go ahead and subscribe to my channel and turn on the post notifications, as this helps me grow a lot. In this video I'm bringing to you three different fixes, and I'm gonna start right off with the first fix, which is the easiest and is the one that works most of the time. What you need to do is to hard reset the Xbox One or perform a power cycle procedure on your Xbox One console. So what you need to do, first of all, you start this operation by ensuring that your console is fully booted and it's not in hibernation mode. Then once you make sure it's on, what you need to do is to press the Xbox button and keep it pressed for about like 10 seconds or more until you see that the front LED light turns off. This will allow you to perform a hard reset. Then after your console shutdowns, you need to let go of the power button and wait for at least 1 minute before starting your console again. And when it's off, you can go ahead and unplug all the cables, the power cord, the internet cord and everything, the HDMI from your Xbox One, and then plug it back on after the minute. Once you successfully done this, go ahead and turn your console back and press the power button, and this should allow your Xbox to start and turn on like it would usually do. Now the second thing you can try is to update the system to fix the Xbox that could be stuck on a green screen because it failed during a system update. So what you need to do is to go to support.xbox.com and then select Xbox One, then go ahead and choose system update. Then click on how to use the offline system update diagnostic tool, and then on Xbox One scroll down and download OSUDT2 in USB drive, and then you're going to install this update using a USB drive. For example, OSUDT2 phase to install, go ahead and restore factory default, download the restore factory defaults files, and then go ahead and press the eject and accessories pairing button at the same time, and then press the power button by holding the first two buttons on your Xbox, then wait for the console to perform a repair, and then when applying update, a message will appear. Go ahead and insert the USB drive in which you put the OSUDT2 file and let the system install it. If the update installing process failed, try to download the restore factory default file, put it on your USB, and then connect your USB to the Xbox One console to reset it into factory settings. You'll be then asked if you want to keep your installed games or not, so go ahead, click yes. Of course, if you do not want to lose your installed games. This should actually help you fix the loading screen error, and then you can go ahead and directly play games again. Then finally, what you can do is the last fix. It is to factory reset your Xbox. Go ahead and hold the eject and the sync button on your Xbox both simultaneously, and then click on the power button. Wait for two startup tones to sound, and then a menu with four options will appear: restart, power off, factory reset, and update off flash drive. What you need to do is to go ahead and click factory reset, and then you'll be asked whether you want to keep your installed games or not. Go ahead and click on keep installed games and let it update for a couple of minutes. Then the Xbox One will boot normally again, and all your game will still be stored on the game drive and the issue will be gone. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and tell me which fix worked for you, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comments down below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace.